Hello and good evening everybody. Welcome you all to today's international webinar on high quality research approach, design and publishing. I am Dr. K.M. Rupa, professor and head of the Department of Mathematics at Bangalore Institute of Technology, a premier engineering institute in Bangalore, Karnataka, and host institute for this webinar. I have great pleasure and honor to welcome our respected principal, Dr. M.U. Ashwath sir, and also our distinguished speaker, Dr. Anand Nair sir.
Thank you.
Also all the faculty members of Bangalore Institute of Technology and participants for the webinar. I am glad to inform that about 400 participants have registered for this webinar from across the country. Firstly, I will request our respected principal, Dr. M.U. Ashwath sir, to give an opening remarks on this occasion. Over to principal sir.
Thank you, Dr. Rupa ma'am. I am very happy to be associated with this event. In fact, in the last few years, colleges like ours were mainly focusing on undergraduate teaching learning activities. It has been become a kind of a mandatory thing that everybody should involve in the research. And the All India Council for Technical Education, that the body who governs technical education in the country, also has given some guidelines for doing the R&D work. And especially in the last 2 years, there's a lot of focus and encouragement and motivation from the Indian government and the state governments for doing a lot of innovative works in the socially relevant thrust areas. So keeping all this, now the teachers are also getting used to understanding the nitty-gritties of research. And, the students are also more innovative these days, and they are exploring a lot of options of doing something different according to them. But the purpose of R&D, what I have understood so far, is to look around, to see the problems the society is facing and find some solutions to these things. Maybe that is a kind of application-oriented research. And some basic research is also going on. But our teachers are now getting used to understanding the issues connected with the research, and they are learning day by day to get into the research field and seriously hook on to their field of expertise and do something. And now these days, everything is measured in terms of outcomes, whether you have got patents, whether you have got publications, and how many papers you have published in national reputed peer-reviewed journals. All these things are becoming as a measure of one's competency, in other words. So looking at all these things, I think this session with Dr. Anand Nair is going to be a very fruitful and valuable discussion to all the participants. And I'm sure at the end of this session, all the participants will get some tips to get into the real research. And I am also eagerly looking forward for the deliberations and understand what exactly we need to do as an head of the organization. So with these few words, I once again thank Dr. Anand Nair for accepting to be the expert speaker today and interacting with all of our participants. So one request all the participants is, when you are not speaking, kindly mute your microphones, and only at the end of the session you can send your queries in the chat box, and maybe those questions can be taken up for question and answer session with Anand Nair. In between, please don't do the chatting, so that it will attract the diversion of the people who are attending the session. So with this request to all the participants, over to Dr. Rupa ma'am for further.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Dr. Vijendra sir, professor of civil engineering in BIT, to introduce our distinguished speaker, Dr. Anand Nair sir, Over to Professor Vijayendra sir, please.
Thank you, madam. So I welcome all the participants, and I'm very happy to give the brief introduction, very elaborative achievements of Anand Nair. So I'll give a brief introduction of the today's speaker. First of all, I welcome and thank our today's speaker, Dr. Anand Nair, who has accepted to deliver the lecture on the research approach, design, and finally publishing. So it should give all our participants, young faculty, and also who are eager to do research. So it will be open up the gates for them. So here, Anand Nair today is with us. He is a faculty in Dai Thanh University of Vietnam. And he has got more than 16 years of teaching experience, also combined with research. He obtained his MCA degree in 2008, followed up by the MPhil in 2009 and MTech, Information Technology, in 2011. Finally, he obtained his PhD degree in 2017 in wireless sensor networks. In between, he also obtained his MBA degree with first division from Manipal University. He has he is a certified professional, and he has got the certification from global IT firms. He has published more than 300 research papers in national and international journals, also in national and international conferences. Apart from that, he has got more than hundreds of scholarly articles in popular magazines like Open Source for You and Electronics for You. Apart from that, he has published more than 22 books in different subjects of the computer science field. As a teaching and research faculty of Dai Thanh University of Vietnam, he has guided more than 40 postgraduate students for their dissertation work, and currently is guiding one PhD student in the area of computer science. Apart from that, he is in the editorial board of more than 300 research journals, and also he is the editor-in-chief of IGA Global Journal, titled International Journal of Smart Vehicles and Smart Transportation. And primarily, he is a thorough researcher, very dedicated and committed researcher, and all this profile clearly indicates his commitment to research. And also, one more feather in his cap is two patents to his credits in the area of speech processing and IoT. He is internationally recognized, and this recognition is evident from his invited talks for more than 20 or so faculty development programs, and he is a well-known keynote speaker in many international arena. And he is a member, active member of more than 50 international and national professional bodies. He is awarded with more than 20 national awards for teaching, research, innovation, and scientific activities. And also, he is very popular among the speakers of YouTube channel with his GAN with Anand Nair. With this brief introduction, I'm happy to welcome Anand Nair and share his thoughts, and also give a motivating talk about how to conduct research or how to be a researcher. Thank you, Rupa Madam, and over to you to continue with the book.
Now over to Professor Anand Nair, sir.
I see the presenter role is fixed on Madhukeshwara. You have to make the speaker as Okay. Yeah, that's right.
Can we start, sir?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, continue, sir.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Dr. Anand Nair, and I'm working as professor, researcher, and scientist in graduate school, Dutan University, Da Nang, Vietnam. Before I start with my presentation and give you the brief introduction about me, as well as take you to the world of a research methodology, let me first of all thank Bangalore Institute of Technology and my special thanks to Professor Dr. Rupa, Professor M.U. Aswath, and Professor Vijendra for keeping in touch with me and making me as a keynote speaker for the next 2 days for this research methodology webinar. Ladies and gentlemen, today we are all want publication. We all want research to be published and recognized by the whole of the world. But frankly speaking, that we all make blunder of mistakes. As an editor-in-chief, I'm telling you that we in a journal receive almost 5 to 7 papers in a week, and only 1 or 2 papers are through from our eyes that can be granted to the reviewers, and maybe out of that 2 or 3 papers, 1 paper get through and we get that paper published into the journal. But the question is that we have to understand the myths, we have to understand the science behind the methodology and how we present that. So doing the research is also very important, but presenting the research in a appropriate manner, that is a different thing that we have to understand. I request all the participants to please mute the mic so that I should not interrupt. Rupa ma'am, please excuse me.
Yes, sir. Please, participant, request all, please mute your microphone, please.
So I hope I should not repeat it again. Thank you so much, because it distracts me. Thank you so much. So before we start with the introduction and everything of research methodology, let me first of all introduce myself. As Dr. Vijendra has given some brief introduction, but I would like to give you some of my detailed introduction and how you can collaborate with me, what are the opportunities of research are available in my university, and how you can sign some collaboration agreement with us. That is very important. And after that, we dive into the research part. I will be putting up the agenda for the 2 days, today and tomorrow, what we are going to do in this workshop. So let me first of all introduce myself. So these are some of the photos that you can see as the glimpses of my life. So on the left hand side, you can see this is my photo in Dev Day Da Nang. This is one of the most important event over here in Vietnam. And last year, I demonstrated my research in the world of Internet of Things, wireless sensor networks, and LoRaWAN. And my research and my speaking was given as the best speaker award. This is one of the best achievements in my life. You can see over here, this is the award that I'm holding with Outstanding Researcher Award. In the history of 25 years, I'm the first foreigner in my university to be awarded by this award. And here is my conference. I'm a chairman of this conference, that is ICIIT 2020. So this year we have done this conference with ACM Digital Library, and all the papers are published in ISI Web of Science, Scopus, as well as DBLP. And next year we are even planning this conference in Ho Chi Minh City. So if you are interested to write a paper and you want to get that paper accomplished, so you are most welcome to write the paper. The website is iciit.org. So here you can see, even I have acted as a speaker in Google I/O, and last year I have explained the elaborations with regard to TensorFlow, Google Machine Learning Kit, and many more. And here is one of my innovations that I've done. This is a smart owl, and this owl can do the temperature, moisture, and even it can control the smart light, smart television, and even your kitchen appliances. So everything can be done with this smart owl. So let me introduce first of all about myself. So I'm working as professor, researcher, and scientist in graduate school, Dutan University, Da Nang, Vietnam. I'm a PhD in computer science in the area for sensors, swarm intelligence, and network simulation, with 16 years of plus of teaching and research experience, and including as consultants for cloud computing, cybersecurity, blockchain, and even artificial intelligence for tons of industry and other freelancer projects and other research projects also. So I'm specialized in WSN, Managed Swarm Intelligence, Machine Learning, Deep Learning, Cloud Computing, Big Data, IoT, Intelligent Computing, Brain Computing, AI, Smart Cities, and many more. I have published current on that this date of today. I have already got 3 acceptances of SCA papers today. So I have published 425 research papers, and out of that, 103 papers are into Scopus and 74 papers are into SCA journals. And by the end of this year, I'm expecting to cross the mark of 100 SCA papers by the end of December 2020. So I've written 50 plus articles in open source for you magazine, which is one of the reputed magazine of Linux and open source. And it is one of the top numbers in the Asia that is I'm having with me. I've published 25 books and 75 plus certifications from various IT organizations like Google, Microsoft, Cisco, CyberRoam, Oracle, many more. With 1,550 plus citations in Google Scholar with H index of 20 and I index of 52, which is a very good and respectable score this time. Even I'm acting as a senior member for IEEE and ACM, and even I'm acting as ACM Distinguished Speaker, the first one and the only one in Vietnam. And even I'm acting as the editor-in-chief of my journal of IGA Global. You are most welcome to add your papers. That is International Journal of Smart Vehicles and Smart Transportation. And by the end of next year, we are expecting to get this journal indexed into Scopus, because recently we have got the indexing of EI CompIndex, Google Scholar, DBLP, and now we are working towards Scopus also. So I'm associated with 500 conferences as national, international reviewer, technical advisory member, proceeding chair, technical program chair, and many other positions. I have delivered more than 200 invited talks in 8 countries, delivered 50 plus keynote talks and 100 plus faculty development programs across 9 countries. I'm a certified drone pilot. Yes, everybody, I'm a certified drone pilot over here with 2 inventions, 3 patents, and 15 copyrights. And I have won 26 awards for my teaching and research. And the recent award that has been given to me is Distinguished Scientist Award. And maybe by the end of this year, we are expecting 3 more awards to be added to my career. So let me start with some motivation for all of you, because research starts with motivation and everything comes from the heart, and we should be happy to do that. So these are the 3 mottos of my life, which is very important for you to understand. The first motto of my life is knowledge for a better world. We all know we are a people of technology, and technology and computer science is actually playing a crucial role to solve lots of problems which can happen in the real world. And even it is known as a blessing to take the mankind to the next level of smart, intelligent, and well-connected world. So the word of 10 years back is different, and word of today is totally different, and the word of future will be totally different. So in order to maintain that clarity, in order to improve yourself, in order to maintain pace with the word of technology, you have to keep yourself updated. And that's why the knowledge empowers thinking, and the thinking empowers mankind, and the mankind leads to a smarter and intelligent world. So keep on updating your knowledge. And even today as a professor, I'm saying you, even today I'm enrolled in lots of courses in Coursera, MIT, and even other universities on Class Central. I will be telling you some of the courses also. And even I attend today lots of FDP programs, which I so like, because I keep myself updated and I want to keep myself updated everywhere. The second. Dr. Rupa?
Yes, sir.
Madam, are you listening to me, please?
Yes, listening, sir, 100%, sir.
Please respond immediately. If you are listening to me, please respond immediately. Now, if
any participant
is found that he is listening and he is unmuting the mic, please try to leave him from the meeting. Remove him from the meeting immediately.
Yes, sir.
This is the second time I'm telling you, please. I hope that this is not should be repeated for the third time, please.
Okay, thank you, sir.
I don't like to repeat myself. Thank you so much.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So the second important motto is, if you're stuck in some problem and no one is supporting you, you try to be relaxed, because God wants you to learn many things. It is very important, and you should always keep on updating yourself. And the third very important thing, as we already told you, that the computer science is made to solve the problem. So as a scientist, even I'm a computer scientist, and we daily find lots of problems in terms of you can say finding the solutions with regard to smart cities, blockchain, AI. So we are not afraid for any types of challenges and hardships. So you please try to be as one of the most important dynamic person and scalable and flexible in order to take up challenges and hardships. So if you follow these three mottos, you are actually leading to a better world and you are actually doing your research. So according to me, these principles are acting as a foundation stone in order to improve your research skills as well as your thinking and implementation skills. Now, let me talk of some of the collaboration opportunities that I'm available for that you can do. So if you have a good student who has done his M.Tech and who is looking for a PhD opportunity, and he is having one of the specializations like cloud computing with machine learning, wireless sensor network, swarm intelligence, grid computing, AI, blockchain. So they are most welcome to join my university as a PhD scholar under me. So I'm having three seats with me, and the eligibility is first class masters with 5 Scopus papers or 2 SCA papers. At least we require 5 Scopus papers with strong skill set in programming, simulation, as well as machine learning and Python based libraries, and willing to do research with passion. And if you are a PhD person and you're looking for a postdoc, I'm saying again, postdoc, that is postdoctoral research, you are again welcome to join the university. So I'm having 2 seats available with me in the world of cloud security and deep learning in wireless communication or 5G or sensor communications. And the eligibility is PhD in computer science or IT with at least 10 SCA papers, and only as the person should act as a first, second or corresponding author. And maximum 4 authors in one paper. So we don't require those papers that are having 5, 7, or 8 authors. We don't require those papers. And strong skill set in programming, machine learning libraries, deep learning, and especially MATLAB, that is important, and plus a skill with live working on embedded systems. So willing to research with passion, with strong teaching and research proposal. So here is the advertisement of my university. You can see Dutan University and the postdoctoral fellow recruitment. And if you are interested, you can send your resume to me. And in the end, I will be giving you my WhatsApp number and even my email ID also. So in order to apply under me, so this is very important for collaboration. So I need your first, that is your brief metadata with 500 words, detailed resume with how many publications you have. And we only look towards publications with SCA journals. Then we look towards Scopus journals or ESCA journals. And then with the conferences that are only with Springer or that is ACM based. So we don't look much towards IEEE conferences. With teaching and research statement, I will be telling you today how to make that with list of top publications, and research should be in the blood and willing to work with passion 24/7. So let me talk of the agenda for today and tomorrow. So today's agenda will be very, very lucrative for all of you. And I will be telling you where we actually make the mistakes and how we have to avoid those mistakes in our research. So today will be the foundation as well as intermediate lecture for all of you, so that for tomorrow's lecture, you are all mentally prepared. So the first thing that we'll be doing today is known as how to make your teaching and research statement. Very, very important, everybody. So second, I will be telling you how to do research. What are the steps that we have to do the research? The third thing, how to send proposals to various professors that, okay, you want to cooperate. Every day I'm getting lots of collaboration emails and even proposals that, sir, we want to collaborate paper with you. We tell you out of 25 to 30 emails, I only reply to 2 emails because of the clarity as well as the objective which we require in order to study with that email. The third thing, that the next thing which we require is to how to read a research paper. That is actually the people make mistakes, and that is how we make a PhD a problem for our career. So next we will try to find out the more solutions with regard to how to write the grant proposal, how to apply for the grant, and what mistakes that we look in order to apply for the grant. And tomorrow we will be speaking towards learning research tools. What are the online tools? What are the websites? And what are the various techniques and softwares that we must use in order to do our research? That is very important. So don't think that only Google Scholar and Google is there, and only you have to go to library to take some research papers and you just have to read them. No, it is not the word. You have to follow lots of tools. So what are those tools? I will be discussing tomorrow practically. After that, I will be telling you how to write a research paper, then the tips to get the acceptance so that the paper should not be rejected. If you get a minor or a major revision, which means the paper is almost safe. So after that, I will be telling you how to write effective thesis during your PhD. And that is where the research scholars make the mistakes. So let me talk of the first important thing, which is available in front of you in your slide right now. That is 7 pillars, according to me, to be a risk effective, which is very important for you to understand. Now, the first important thinking, where everybody have creative thinking and think towards future and have the sky high thinking that, okay, if you say that it is impossible, you are not a researcher, because if you talk of 10 years back, you don't imagine that how much internet can be progressive and how much technologies in terms of websites and in smartphones, how much can be improved. There was a time when I have to carry an iPod, a camera and other things in order to go for a picnic. But today I only carry my iPhone. So everything has been changed and club together towards one device. So have a sky high thinking and always say nothing is impossible. So always think creatively that it can be done. Yes, it can be done. Let's work on that. So everything is possible. There is nothing impossible in the world of research. So the second thing, very important, please be aware and informed of everything in your field. Love everything and respect everything. Gone were the days when people used to say that, okay, sir, in computer science, I'm master in networking, I'm master in databases, I'm master in AI. But now it is not like that. All the fields are now clubbing together and they are coming together under one roof in order to provide a solution. So please be connected, be aware and should be informed. So we have lots of websites. We have lots of things to be done in this webinar. I will be telling you how to stay connected and aware of every field that you're doing your research. So the third important thing, have strong networking and always be in touch with them. So the most important thing is whether it is a Facebook or whether it is LinkedIn, people all say that these are the best social media. But tomorrow I will be giving you some important tools that will help you to bridge up your gaps. Or I can say you can have a good bridge between the research community as well as you can able to understand which are the people who are actually doing the work into your field and can get connected with them. This is very important for you to understand. After that, keep an eye on the problems that are coming up and be the first one to take up the challenge. Very, very important. Because if you are the first one, then let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, you can just publish paper and you can just be there into one of the researchers among the Google Scholar. You will not be regarded as a top cited scholar. So be the first one to keep an eye on the problems, because the leader always wins. So have a strong goal on the English and communication skills and high ethics on emails, how to have your good presentation and leadership skills, because the most important thing where we communicate and how the better language that we use in order to write an email, I will be also telling you how to write an email tomorrow. So this is very important for you to collaborate. And the next important thing, which is very, very important, all of you, even I've told you that even as a professor today, I do lots of courses on Class Central, Coursera, MIT OpenCourseWare, and even other FDP programs. So keep on learning. Learning never stops. And always think yourself that you are a student, not teacher, that, okay, I'm a student today, I want to learn something. Because in computer science, if you're not a learner, you can't be able to solve the problems. Your growth will immediately be hampered, because in this world of computer science, everything changes like this and this. So the most important point is never retire. Teachers retire, army men retire, but the researchers and scientists, they never retire. So we always say, and even this is my thinking, if you are tired, you are retired. So whether you are retired, so go home. But if you are a researcher, you never say that you are tired, because if you are tired, it means that you have already given the hands off that, okay, I don't want to grow. But in computer science, if you're not growing, you are not flexible or robust, please leave this field, because this field is a challenging field for you. So it doesn't matter where you start and how you start. The only thing is to begin. So let's begin the journey, ladies and gentlemen. So let us start the first topic of the today's webinar, getting the interview. Excuse me, Rupa ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Madam, yes, people are leaving, so please, they are distracting actually.
Okay, sir.
Kindly check in this, please. Okay. So let us talk of the most important thing today. And if you want apply for a foreign university, and if you want to apply for a good research association, the most important thing that the people say that, oh, we need a resume, we need publications. But there are two most important documents that are required. That is your teaching and research statement, which is very, very important. And I don't know how many institutions of India, they take the teaching statement and research statement, but in the foreign universities, it is very important that you must be carrying your teaching and research statement along with you in order to prove your worth in terms of teaching as well as research. So in this lecture, we will be covering regarding how to prepare the cover letters, that is how to prepare the teaching as well as the research statements. So the first important thing is that in order to understand what is meant by teaching and research statement, we should understand that these are the four important positions in the world of research. So the first position, that is called postdoc. Now, let me tell you what is actually meant by postdoc. Many people are having the myth. So postdoc should not be treated as a degree, or it should not be treated as a diploma or other things. It is just a sequence of collaboration that you are connected to a particular lab and a professor, and you and his qualifications and his specializations, they are actually matching up each other. And he has a project and he wants your help in order to solve that project. So in order to meet with him, in order to be in a position, in order to solve a particular problem in a particular lab, that is actually known as the period. And for that period, you're doing a collaborative research and you're solving a problem and you're assisting him in the research. So that is the reason we can say that it is called a postdoc program. So in that postdoc program, you can even go for like funding of the project. You can even go for publications. You can even go for the teaching, and even you can have strong networking. So for that position, we actually require the teaching and the research statement. Very, very important. The second thing is whether you want to. Madam, is there any problem with the screen?
Sir, it's not moving, actually. Nothing is.
Yes, ma'am. Screen is not.
Okay, sir. Sir.
Is the screen visible?
Sir, visible, but your slide is not, visible, sir.
So the second position that we talk about, the teaching and research statement, is known as adjunct and part-time faculty, which means that you want to become a part-time teaching, or whether you want to become a seasonal teacher or a part-time teacher. Very important. And the third important thing is known as a permanent, or for a permanent position-based faculty, that is known as a tenure track. So if you apply for a foreign university, very important for you to understand that if you want to go for visiting professor, if you want to go for like a particular project, or you want to go for a seasonal faculty, everything, they are having the positions. But if you want to go for a regular position or a permanent position, that, okay, I want to be there for a visa of 3 years, 5 years, or maybe 10 years, I want to apply for assistant or associate and then professor, you can work for the tenure track position. Tenure track means the regular position and full-time position in a university or a college in a foreign university. So we have the entrepreneurial activity, which means that now you started your own company and you'll be your own boss. So these are the four important positions. So these are this is where the teaching and research statement is actually required. So the question stands today that where do I find the job postings and opportunities? Very important for you to understand. So the first important website that I can give you is known as academicpositions.com. Please keep a note on it, because some people say that, sir, we want to get association for postdoc, we want to go association for PhD, et cetera, et cetera. No doubt LinkedIn is there, but academicpositions.com is one of the best reference that you can take. Then we have conferences, not ordinary conferences, but international conferences. And I always motivate my students and even my collaborators that at least once time a year, but this year is just a, you can say, pandemic situation, even I'm stuck. So every year, at least go to visit to two at least countries so that you can understand what the research is going on. You can have community collaborations. You can have linkage with the professors, and you can collaborate with them on some important projects as well as grant-based orientations. Very important. So the third is known as ResearchGate. If you are not on ResearchGate, you are not on the research network. So please keep a close eye on the researchers and please follow them so that you should understand what their work is doing, and you can cite their recent papers. And if you get a recent paper, like I published the recent papers on the ResearchGate network, I get lots of emails with regard to questions, queries, collaborations, lots of things. ResearchGate network improves your clarity. So we have the ACM Communication Magazine, that is also very important. So if you're not subscribed to ACM Digital Library, so there is no need to worry. You can just search ACM Communication Magazine. Yeah, this magazine will also lay a strong foundation for having the research linkage. Then please have a strong link with the networks, recognition with a strong publication, active member on social media. I'm talking of LinkedIn right now and ResearchGate, but tomorrow I will be telling you what is actually meant by the social media websites. It is not even Facebook. It is not Twitter that we stay in touch. There are other websites through which you should be in touch, and you can be having the strong profile in order to make your work known to whole of the world. So we have the LinkedIn network also. So in short, you are going for the job search, talk to your network, activate your connections, contact your referees, collect the documents which are necessary, subscribe to the databases, classified and social networks, attend meetings and workshops. And the most important thing, everybody, is network, network, and network. And ladies and gentlemen, very important for you to understand that if you are on LinkedIn, please keep a close eye on the search key terms like research, researchers, research network. So please try to search them regularly, because most of the eminent scholars, they add this hashtag and they can be in touch with you and you can connect to them, and they will be a blessing for your life. Because I always keep a close eye on these three hash networks, that is research, research network, and researchers, because this will give you a good exposure in order to connect to the best people in the world, and you can be a benefited towards their network. So the question is, what is actually required in order to become a good position in the foreign university? Many people ask me this question. So the first important thing is the general information, your CV, your cover letter, letter of recommendation, number of references, and even your transcript. So transcript means what is being done, what is your journey from the start to today. Very important for you. So the second thing is known as your teaching information. So what is your student ranking? What subjects you are specialized? What is your methodology of teaching? How you actually be an active role into the core teaching activities? How you update yourself? What is your pedagogy for teaching? Very important. And after that, the bit obvious is known as your research information, your copies of publication, research plan, and even your research interest, which is very, very important. Because if you talk of foreign universities, you don't have a position like associate professor for computer science. You have specialist positions, because right now in my university, I'm a professor for artificial intelligence and cloud computing. So I'm specialized into these two main, and into my teaching, I'm connected to like professor of software engineering and professor of cybersecurity. So I'm having these four positions in my university, in which these four domains, I'm actually connected to my teaching and do my research into different domains. So in order to find a cover letter, the most important thing is we need to have the 1 or 2 pages maximum in order to portray the resultant fit, in order to make yourself fit to the institution. So please have a good research that before you connect to a particular institution or a research engineer, please have a depth knowledge of that how your scope matches to their research interest. So have a proper opening paragraph that what you are, then you should write your teaching statement, something that what is your teaching, how the teaching is improved with you, research statement, and the closing remarks. Very important, everybody. So in order to apply for the cover letter, the most important thing, in order to even write a research paper, I will be also telling you tomorrow that if you submit a research paper, you have to give a cover letter. That in cover letter, many people make the mistake that, respected sir, I am this person and I am submitting this paper title and hope you can accept our paper. This is not a cover letter. Okay, so cover letter should clearly state what is the novelty of the research and what are the conclusions that you have done in your research paper, so that editor-in-chief can understand that this is the paper that is actually matching my scope and this is the paper that is actually looking different and new in terms of the contributions. So cover letter should actually portray yourself in order to have the motivation, what is your learnings, what is your accomplishment, what is your your active roles in different communities. So this is all important in the cover letter. So this is what we actually see in the person when we start a particular collaboration. So please write your description in terms of your teaching and even describes regard to your accomplishments as well as your special achievements. That what have you done, like 100% result in last 4 years, best teacher award from this institution last year. So this is known as accomplishment, so that the person can able to understand that what kind of teacher and what kind of skill activities. And you should also have a department vision. Because why? Because tomorrow, if you apply for a good university, they always say that the person should be able to do research into information systems. The person should provide a good, strong results with the students with regard to AI and cybersecurity. So you should integrate your mission and vision in order to divert that, okay, sir, I'm the fit man for this position and I am the person you are actually looking for. So this is very important. And after that, add your experience and how you value to highlight. So what is your experience, what was your position, and at that position, what were your key responsibilities and what special role you have played. This should be all mentioned in the cover letter. So every one line, or I can say 5 to 7 lines in terms of your teaching contribution, it is very important and will give a good diligence for you to play a strong role that you should get a call. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, my one of the friend is in USA. I will not take the name of the university. He told me one day that if your cover letter is not strong, we even don't open the resume, which means that the person is not self-motivated and he doesn't want to produce himself in front of us that he is ready and fit for this job. So that is the reason, everybody, that cover letter is the founding stone that whether institution will pick up your resume or whether it will not pick up your resume. So the another thing that is very important is known as your research inspirations and what are your goals? What is your research goal? What particular activity you are working on and what is your desire to accomplish? So that the university should understand that if the person is working on this and this is his vision that he wants to do like that, otherwise you cannot be a strong player for the university of the near future. So always state your closing paragraph with regard to the valuation and what you're looking for in terms of research. So these are the four important things for cover letter: the general statement, the introduction statement, body paragraphs, as well as the conclusion. So if you have these four important activities, everybody, because let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, in order to perform a research, in order to become a good researcher, it is very important for you to become a good representer, first of all. Because if you're not a good representer, if you are not collaborated with strong people and you don't know the knack how to get connected with them, you are actually not completing yourself. Connection complete you, research improves you, and the publication recognizes you. This is what my motto is. So do remember, everybody, connections play a crucial role. So you can see over here, I have given you one example that what is the date, what is the company name, company address, and what is the salutation, which means who is the person. So generally we take as a HR person or the like a vice chancellor, or even we can go for dean academics, like all these things. So the introduction, introduce who you are and what is the position, how you heard about the position, state your degree, college and graduation date, and also claim about your competency. What is your specialization? After that, please demonstrate your past experience, current skills, highlight your skills, how you can improve the university, elaborate your research and professional experience, and also type some of your research accomplishments or teaching accomplishments like your awards, grants, or any other, like you can say that you have done some project with the students or you have won some competition, hackathon. All these things will be countable. And after that, please conclude that what is being done as a strong candidate for you, so you should be getting the email. So this is one of the example that you can see, and this is one of the best letter that I can produce in front of you, that how the person is applying for a computer vision engineer position. Because in foreign universities, we have different positions. It is not only computer science position. So recently in our university, we have some positions with regard to augmented reality engineer, computer vision engineer, research into machine design, research into automation. So all these type of positions we have, but we need to have some specialization skills in order to grab the best position. So that is how you have to maintain your cover letter in order to apply for the position. Now, it is very important for you to understand, illustrate how you are unique in a personal way. Very, very important. So this is important tip, because today I'm giving you important tips also. Tomorrow, I will be also telling you what mistakes we make in our research paper. So understand carefully. So the teaching statement, now most important for the teaching statement, though, how you evaluate your student. What is your criteria that, okay, sir, I evaluate the students on the basis of projects, on the basis of multiple choice questions, and I do assignments like this positions. Letter of recommendations, experience, philosophy of teaching, that how pedagogical, what type of teaching methodological tools you use in order to improve your teaching, and how you quality demonstrate. So this is all the five important activities that you actually require for teaching statement. So please define how you define yourself as a teacher. Second, what idea you have, what is your tenure, what was the position or current position that you have, awards and interview, and please clarify your once teaching. Very, very important, everybody. So in order to conceptualize that, you see that I believe students who learn by this methodology, I believe the role of teacher is, and apart from it, please stress on your knowledge, your skills, creativity, and discuss why these important points are to you and how you accomplish them in the class. So that is the reason, everybody, that if you are going for the interview today, the people want to have a demo class so that they should understand how effectively you can demonstrate the concept. And that is what we see in our university, because if you are really interested to join the university, we always say that what kind of pedagogical terminologies and what kind of techniques you use in order to communicate with the student, and how you communicate with all of the class. You don't skip any of the student. You take whole of the class with you. So this is very important for you to understand. So in order to have the considerations, you can find that what is your teaching philosophy, your evaluations, and how you can create an inclusive learning environment, which is very known for diversity in environment. Because in the foreign universities, you have people not only from one you can say creed or one country. In my class, I have students from China, from Korea, from Cambodia, Laos, and even from Malaysia. So I interact all of them because they're coming from different cultures and they have their unique different points to teach. So that becomes not a challenging job, but it becomes a diverse task to improve your pedagogy in teaching. So the important tip is concentrate on examples and please from your experience, please. Very important. Please mention your experience. And please have your considerations in order to have the citations and the various type of research areas and what type of specializations you have in your teaching. So keep it brief and don't reproduce your CV and please have it all. Because in teaching statement, what we see is that how effective teacher you are, what is your pedagogy, what is your methodology, what tools you use, what are your evaluation criteria, and how you make your subject become easy and less challenging and easy to cope up for the students of diverse culture. That is what we see and that is what you have to divert yourself, that you are a teacher from the core of the heart. So never stretch about the truth. Very important. So never be too honest. I openly say never be too honest. You can overstate yourself that, okay, sir, I can communicate like this. I can use like a visual aids, etc., etc. So only thing is you have to have a proper demonstrate in order to understand that you are actually becoming as an effective teacher. So the very useful advice is to have a symbolic meaning and you should have universities proclaim value that what is your teaching culture and how you are getting preferred into rehot experience. So in order to find the teaching statements very challenging, so you can say that sometimes the audience and expectations are very unclear. Sometimes the gender is unclear. Sometimes the people don't say you that, okay, sir, you have to teach with a graduate class or postgraduate class, because in my university, we have different pedagogies for graduation class and for post-graduation, because we have long teaching hours for graduation and even have long lectures for them. But for the master class, we have most time for the discussions as well as project and orientations towards reports. So that is what we have to teach in the class with terms of forums, and we have to solve their problems rather than to develop their critical thinking because they're already experienced. So we have to find out the effective outcomes in order to have your passion, and we have to find out your academic pros. Very, very important. Now, in order to find out your research statement, this is the most challenging part that people make the mistakes. And that is what you have to make it sure that your teaching, your research statement should be very important, because today's universities, ladies and gentlemen, they always see your research. So if tomorrow, if you're going for accreditation, you are going for any MOU, if you're going for any grant-based project, it is only seen that what kind of research atmosphere you have. And even in the foreign universities over here, they are not even connected with your PhD. Also, they have not even asked me that whether you are a PhD from an IIT or from a foreign university. They only ask me what is your publication record. And if your publication record is not good, let me tell you, you are not having a good profile. So in terms of research statement, the first important thing is your aims. What is the area that you are working? What is the goal and what is the significance in the real time? So please connect your research interest. The most important thing is what is your potential, that how you can solve the problem and what is your productivity in the research, that what is the area that you target, like SCA journals, transactions, Nature journals, and even you can target some of the grant projects you signed for the MOU, lab-based visits, conference-based visits, whatever you have done, it should be there in the research statement. So in the research statement, you even have to cite your top 5 papers, the problems orientation that you have solved in order to make your research-based effective things. So always show your link. Most important, everybody, if you are really applying for a good university and you are applying for a good research position, show your link between the teaching and research. And that is what you can say, that even in my university, I show a strong link that how my research with artificial intelligence and machine learning is improving the situation for the students, and they're doing hackathon and they're producing effective projects. Okay, so have a complete bridge between your research and teaching, because they go hand in hand over here. So always have a second and third option, because you can go for like an opinion that, okay, whether it is okay or whether it is not. Because sometimes when I get the thesis, when I get the CVs of the people that, okay, sir, please check the CV for this interview. Even I'm also connected to some of the institutions in India. I will not take the name. I regularly take the interview for the people, and sometimes the CVs are very, very pathetic, I can say. Even they have 7 to 10 years experience, but the CVs look very, very, you can say, pathetic CVs that you can say. So have a proper spelling and grammar check and punctuation, because tomorrow I will be also stressing this important aspect, that how to have the last grammar checks as well as the punctuation checks. I will be telling you two important softwares, not Grammarly, not Ginger. There are two important softwares that you should use in order to check your grammar and punctuation. Very, very important. So always have your references, because references play a crucial role. So please have a good references and good recommendation letters from your references. And always present your best self, because what the best you are and how much activities you are doing and what is the best and the best outcome that you can give in order to turn your institution into the research oriented university or a college in the near future. So always have a plan B and plan C, because if one university is not giving you, which means you are able to apply for the next university, but keep your cover letter, research, teaching, publications, resume always updated. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, every Saturday on the afternoon, I just don't do any work. I just stop my work and I just keep on updating my resume, that what I have done in 1 week, and I have to update my resume like anything, because if I'm not updating my resume in a month, at least for half of the page or one of the page, I will say myself that I'm not doing my job correctly. Right now, I'm saying it openly in front of you. My resume is about 344 pages, I can say. So across all the three, the most important thing is be short and be comprehensive. Very important. You should have to be short, but you have to be comprehensive. Support by the evidence. You should be unique, connected, confident, factual, correlated with your intellectual activity, and sensibly conducted. Very, very important. So these are some of the references of the YouTube, which you can see online on YouTube, that how you can write your teaching and research statement and how the selection takes place for a researcher or a professor or even as a scientist in one of the universities. This is very important criteria for you to understand. So these are some of the resources that I've used in order to make it. And if you have any question, you can write it on Cisco WebEx. But after that, I will not close the session. We will have a question answer session for 10, 15 minutes where you can ask me the questions. Now, before, ladies and gentlemen, I should dive into the research lecture. Let me give you first of all, the details of some of the books that I use and I always recommend to some of the courses, that if you're doing a PhD or whether you are a research scholar or whether you are doing for postdoc or whether you want to publish a research paper, please read these books. So the first important book that I would like to inform all of you is this book, which every PhD scholar should read. This is known as Thesis Writing for Masters and PhD Program. So don't worry, I will be sharing all these books after this webinar to Madam Rupa, and she will be giving you these books after that. So the first book that I would like to recommend all of you, it is from Springer, you can see, and this is Thesis Writing for Masters and PhD Program. Tomorrow I will be telling you how to write an effective thesis. Very important. Now this one, everybody, this is again an eye-opener session for all of you. So please use this book also to consult that how to have an effective thesis writing, how to write better thesis. Ladies and gentlemen, when I was writing the thesis, I swear to God, because some people don't believe me, but I say it is a swear to God and I'm speaking the truth. I have written my thesis only in 17 days, 1-7. And after that, I submitted my thesis on the 18th day to the guide, and guide has taken 3 days to read my thesis, and he has returned 2 mistakes to me, just 2 corrections. And after that, on the 25th of the day, I have just submitted the thesis. So in just less than 1 month, I have written the thesis, I have got it corrected, and even my plagiarism was 7%, and I even submitted the thesis to my university. And all happened in 25 days, even less than 1 month. So it is only because that I was having a proper pedagogy and proper methodology and concepts in order to improve my thesis and to have a proper series and sequence in order to write my thesis. So this book will help you. Now, the next book, which is very important for all of us to read, this is very good book that you can read, all of you, How to Write and Publish Scientific Paper. Very important, because even today you can see how to publish the paper, preparing the test, preparing the tables and figures. I will be telling you tomorrow how to have some certain tools. People use mostly Word or Excel in order to make the tables and figures, but the people don't know what are the actual tools that are being used in order to draft the figures and tables. I will be telling you tomorrow. Now, the next book, which I would like to inform all of you, is very important, How to Survive Your PhD. What mistakes we make in the PhD and how to survive your PhD in effective manner. This is very important. And the next book, which I would like to tell you, this is what we will be discussing after 5 minutes, How to Write Effective Research Proposals. Very important. Everybody, let me tell you, sometimes when I get the email from the people that, okay, sir, we want to do some collaborative work with you. Sir, we want to join PhD with you. Okay, I tell them, okay, but what is your proposal? What do you want me to do the work? What work do you want to do with me? And they are not able to present themselves. So that is a problem, everybody, that we have seen, that the people are not giving the proper research proposal. So I will be telling you how to actually draft the research proposal. And if you are not able to drafting the proper research proposal, let me tell you, no guide and no university will able to entertain you. So ladies and gentlemen, the first mistake that I would like to highlight in this session is that why PhD students are getting harassed, that they are not having a proper research proposal and they just clearly go open-handed and open brain that, okay, sir will give me the topic and I'm going to follow him. No, you are actually making the big mistake. Please have a research proposal and I will be telling you how to start your PhD after 10-15 minutes. Now, the next book which I would like to inform all of you is known as this one, How to Get Research Published in Journals. So this is again a very secret book that almost nobody knows about this type of book. So please know that these books are very important to understand that even publication is not important. Even today, I'm saying you openly, even if today you publish a paper in Transaction, even the publication work, if you say that the publication after publication, the work is over, I'm done. It is not done. It is only 70% of the task. Even let me tell you, there is also a task to be done even after your publication is done. Otherwise, your paper will go into the dust or into the old ages of the history. Okay, so don't worry, Madam Soma, I have told you that the books will be shared to you. So don't worry, just please sit back, relax and enjoy the session, please. Please have the knowledge. Thank you. Now, let me start with some of the sessions now. So the first important session that we will be doing in order to do what is research and how to do it. So I just take a break for 2 minutes and after that we will be starting. So if you have any question, please post it over here. Madam Rupa?
Yes.
Madam, we have a break for 2 minutes and after that we start the session again.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Request to participant, mute everyone, your phone, microphone and also video, please.
No problem, madam. And madam, you can give me an email day after tomorrow so that I can give you these books. Okay?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
No problems. Madam, after every presentation, I will be taking a break for 5 minutes so that the people can write. And after that, we will be continuing with the presentations.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. Actually, we are under lockdown, madam, and the situation over here in Vietnam is not correct these days.
Okay, sir.
Actually, we're in lockdown and there is lots of warmness today.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I will be telling you the examples, no problems.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, sir, tell us some example of software name which can help us for checking the grammatical and spelling error during thesis preparation. So I've already told you that today is not the session for research tools, but tomorrow I will be telling you some of the tools that are even better than Grammarly and they reduce the plagiarism and even they improve the English level. And most of all, they're available free of cost. So I will be telling you tomorrow. Okay. Yeah, if you are a BSc student and if you want to make a career into physics like MIT, and let me tell you, it's a myth for everybody that some of the gifted people can go abroad and the MIT requires the IIT people or NIT people. It's just a myth. Okay, so if you're a BSc student and you want to go for MIT, the only stress that the MIT sees is your projects, is your real-time implementation and the problem solutions. So please focus more on the projects and more time, real-time solutions, and even like how much you are connected with some of the research labs. Okay. So even if your grade is like 6.5 or 7 CGPA, even you will be eligible for MIT, because MIT sees your works rather than the grades. It is very important. And even I would like to inform all of you that even today, most of the companies like Apple, Microsoft, and Google, they are just looking towards those people who can solve the problem. So that is the reason today more than 100 people are being employed, which are even less than 15 years of age. They are not even the college students. They are just the school students, and they're working with top corporate giants in order to design the projects and even the softwares. So over there, only skills and even your problem solutions, they come into being. Okay. So don't worry for anything. Yeah, for the postdoc, I've already told you that you have to apply for the university. So depending on the postdoc, that what type of specialization that you have, like in my university, we have projects that are connected to 5G, cloud computing, blockchain, and artificial intelligence. So we have to check your background check with regard to what is your contribution in that particular area. And after that, you can apply with your publications, with your teaching and research statement. This is what I have told you in the lecture number one. That is very important, because even if you want to apply for MIT or for a postdoc, or even for your PhD, your teaching, research, and your publications, these are the three important things that we look towards. And that is what I have cleared it today. And that is how, after that, your profile will be evaluated on the basis of your solutions, on the basis of your contributions, as well as your publication parameters. Everything will be checked. And if it is okay, you will be getting the call. So the most important thing I would like to inform you, that postdoc is not for everyone, because 100 people apply, only one or two positions are there, maybe every year, for a particular university. In my university, we have only two positions right now, and maybe if I get these two positions, I will be not opening up any position for the next 3 years. Okay, so you can do that. So let's start the lecture, madam. Can we start, madam?
Yes, sir. Yeah, yes, sir.
And I hope participants are enjoying the lecture. Okay.
Yes, sir.
It will become more elaborative after 5 to 10 minutes, because today, right now, I'm making your base that how to actually conduct the research and how to not to make mistakes when you go for connectivity and what type of research you want to have. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So, ladies and gentlemen, let us start with the most important lecture for today. And please, I would like to inform all of you that this is just a 9 slides lecture, and this is going to change your life today. So please be very careful, and please be attentive in the lecture, and please take your pen and paper in order to jot down the important points. Okay, but I will be giving this presentation to madam, so don't worry, and please jot down your own points what I'm speaking, because what I'm speaking, it is not always available for you. So presentation will be available for you. Okay, so even though you have the presentation, but you will not have the knowledge unless you don't listen to me very carefully. And please listen to this lecture very carefully. If you don't understand this lecture, the next lecture when you will go tomorrow, that how to write SCA paper, you will not be able to understand my talk. So please be very careful for the next 15 minutes. This will give you a good platform today. Now the question comes, what is research and how to do it? Now the first answer to all of you, even if you are doing a research and the research is not giving you new results, even though it is a research. Even you have proposed something, and if your proposed work is less than as compared to the already performed work, even though it is a research. Research contains invention, it even contains evolution, and it even contains innovation. So every three words, even you are innovating something, you are evaluating something, you are designing the new basic theories, or whether you are inventing something, it is all connected to the research. So research is everything. And even let me tell you, even if I today tell you that, okay, let us make a computer with a budget of 1 lakh rupees. And even today you are doing a research that which motherboard we should use, what hard disk we should, what the SSD we should use, whether we should go for M.2 drive, what type of, you can say, cooling system we should use. So which means that you are doing that, you have tons of products, but you are doing some research in order to find that what is the best effective use of the money and how you can make the best use. So whatever the problem is in front of you, everybody, whatever the problem is in front of you, and you are giving your thought how to solve that problem, you are actually doing the research. So even today I tell you, okay, I am having a budget of 50,000 rupees. Can you list me that which laptop I should buy? Okay, I have tons of phones today. Okay, I have the budget of 18,000 rupees, but I want that. Okay, I only want Android latest version, and secondly, I want minimum 15 to 18 megapixel camera. So this is my requirement, and I want dual SIM, which means these are my parameters, and you have tons of the phones available. Which phone is best for me? So even that is a research. So if today your PhD guy tell you that, okay, please crawl some papers and give me what is the problem that is being observed, what is the problem that yet to be solved, even it is a research. Even let me tell you today, ladies and gentlemen, research starts with a problem. Yes, it starts with a problem. Even if today you're finding a problem or you are doing the existing literature that what is to be done, what is the problems in the work today, even it is a research. So everything that starts with a problem and finding a solution to a particular problem, that is all connected to the research. So ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the foundation stone of research work. So the question is, what is research and how to do it? Now listen, first of all, prepare yourself psychologically. Psychologically means that you should have the three important texts in order to be a researcher. The first thing, be open to learning. If you are not learning, you are not open to thinking, you are not able to do the research. The second important is be always informed and aware what is happening. Whether it is a newspaper, whether it's a website, whether it's a blog, whether it's a YouTube video, whether it's a paper, you should be always informed what is happening. And the third important work, which is that how you express your ideas in order to perform it. So if you are not creative, if you are not expressing, you are not thinking, let me tell you, you are not psychologically prepared. So prepare yourself psychologically. So the first important thing is being a good student enough? I have already answered this question to this person that who wants to go to MIT. I have already told you that it is not important that you should be a gold medalist or university topper. The only thing is you have a creative thinking and you have something to prove yourself that, okay, I can think like this and I have solved this particular problem. Everybody will come to you. Marks don't matter. Everybody. Marks don't matter. So neither it is necessary or neither it is sufficient. Most important. Second thing, do you know your intellectual or mental limit? So the answer comes in front of you. Ready for failures. Be ready for failures. And let me tell you, everybody, most of the people, when they come to me that, sir, we have a research paper. Can you find it? Can you find some problems? And I always say to them the first thing that if you are not open to criticism, if you are not open to welcome my comments that, okay, this is a rustic paper. This is a very bad paper. What is this? You are not able to listen to it. If you are not open to criticism, you are not opening for the research. So always listen to criticism because you are actually improving yourself. Okay, so whether it's a good criticism or whether it's a bad criticism, you should be open for that. So the third important thing, are you extremely motivated? Very important. All you need is passion. Very important. These three points is going to change you today. Okay. And fourth, which is very important, research is not a job. It is more like a hobby. In my veins, let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, maybe you will laugh, but I don't care that whether you will laugh or not. In this veins, I don't say everybody that we have this one called blood or these veins. I say it is 10101. In my veins, it is always 10101. I love the computer science. It's a part of my body. So it is like a blood. Maybe computer science would be a job for you. Maybe a research would be like a stick or a gun in your head that, okay, you have to do something. But for me, I just enjoy this work. Okay, so this is what we have should have. Research is not a job, but it is more like a hobby. So what is research, everybody? Very important. What is the difference between a homework problem and a research problem? So very important, and this is where we actually, and some of the people say me openly that, sir, our students, why the company say, and why we say in the parliament that, okay, 70% of the engineers are not employable. You know why they are not employable? I'm going to answer this question right now. And if you agree with this answer, please put some comment over there in the comment section. I'm welcome for this comment. You know what is the problem? Because the teachers give wrong assignments to the students. They always give, what is this? What is that? Give one example, write the differences. Okay, solve this particular question, which is readily available on the internet, which means that the student just go on the internet, they just do the books and they just do the copy paste. And after that assignment is done. But the main thing where we actually start the assignment is to give the problem that, okay, this is your problem. This is the case study. Now we have discussed the software engineering that, okay, sir, we have discussed waterfall, prototype and rapid and a spiral model. Now I am your client. I have come for this Android app development. This is my constraint. This is my work and this is my budget. Now, which model you will do in order to perform this? through which now in the class, you have understood what is waterfall, what is prototype, what is spiral. But with the assignments, you are actually teaching the student how to apply your knowledge in order to solve the problem. And that is the problem, everybody, in India, that we actually don't go for problem solution. We just give them a 3 hours paper, 3 hours paper that, okay, what is this? What is that? No case study orientation paper is coming. And let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, why Indian education system is lagging, because we don't invite case study orientation problems. And that is the main thing today. Number one point, what is the difference between homework problem and a research problem? So now the question stands in front of you. If I as a teacher give you, okay, what is ransomware? Now, is this a question? Or if I give you a question, okay, this is the virus. Now find out how this virus behaves. Now identify whether it's a worm or whether it's a ransomware and what you will do in order to safeguard your network from this type of virus. So that the person should understand what is the problem is there. He should identify the criticism and after that he can find some solution. Then only he can apply his skills in order to find a solution. And that is the problem, everybody, that we are actually focusing on homework problem. We are not focusing on the research problem. And that is the problem with the PhD, because till MTech, what we have done, we have just written the assignments, we have done written this work and etc. But if you're going for a research paper, how can you make that student compatible for that? You are not able to make that, and PhD will become a problem for him. And that is a problem, because he's a homework solution. He's a homework problem guy. He's not a research problem guy. And that is a problem. That is how we have to start the research. So probably not. Accept your fear. So don't be fear, everybody. Make a problem for you. Okay. That we want to apply a particular problem. So research is anything but homework. Yes, it is not a homework. It is anything. I have already told you. Even if today your father tells you that, okay, son, we want to buy an AC for our room, you must find out that, okay, whether your room is big or small, what is the AC, what are the features or characteristics we have to see, and then we have to decide that which AC is best for us. But the only thing is, we have to find value for the money. We have to be in the budget. We have to find the best product for us. These are the constraints. And even let me tell you, everybody, we all say, yes, everybody, I'm showing it openly. We all say that, okay, let us go for A plus B whole square. And we all say A square plus B square plus 2AB. But if I ask the people in the real time where actually A plus B whole square comes, nobody will answer to me. We all know, even in one of the class of my, when I was in India, I was asking one question to the class that what is meant by mean? And the people say sum of observation divided by number of observations. They were correct. But I asked them one question. Have I asked you this formula? This is a formula. I have told you what is mean and where it is applied. And everybody was like this, because we teach statistics, but we don't know how to do that. And you know, even everybody, even if you have a particular budget, yeah, like suppose you make a budget that, okay, we want to buy a laptop in 70,000. And the main requirement is that at least we must buy 16 GB RAM expendable to that and et cetera, for this type of value money. You are actually doing linear programming for that. You have the constraints, you have the objective, you have to maximize your function. That is actually how you start your research. If you don't know linear programming, you can't start the research. What are your constraints? What is going to be maximized? What is the main things? So that is how we actually apply in the real world. But now I ask many people, I openly say, today you actually know what is actually how the linear programming is actually applied in the real world. Even if you want to buy a refrigerator in your home, you have a budget, you have a constraint, you have to have some value for the money. Even you are applying the linear programming in that. So the only problem is we have to weigh the thinking. So research is anything, everybody. The main thing is, we have to make our orientation towards thinking and solutions. And that is what the students don't know. And that's why we always shout like in the parliament that 70% of the engineers are not employable. They are not employable because actually you have not made them employable ready because of this important question, difference between homework and research problem. So make it a note, everybody. So finding a good problem, even you can see it's a part of the research. Yes. Now today, if you tell me that, okay, sir, let us have some problem that, okay, I want to do a security algorithm in cloud computing. Now what the people will say, okay, sir, start reading the papers. No, I will be telling you how to do PhD. The first thing is, what do you know about security? Do you know how the cryptography works? How the security is applied in cloud computing? What is the problem in the security? So even today, if you're searching for a new problem, even though it starts the research. So that's how we become apart from that. That is why we say it is not a job. It's a hobby. It's a passion. We have to be psychologically ready in order to solve a particular problem. Now, research is about pushing the limits. And that's why you can understand with my language today, you have to push your limits. You have to think how it is actually applied in the real time. You will be stunned to note, everybody, our Indian education, I'm not pointing to any other country. I have been to Singapore, I have been to Korea, I have been to China, I have been to USA. Now I'm going to Switzerland next year for one of the conference. And I have seen only problem-oriented education in order to perform the study. But in our country, I'm saying it openly, we only have theoretical study. Many people will give, let's take an example of software engineering. Many people can give you the answer that, okay, sir, what is waterfall? What is spiral? What is agile? But now if I ask them one question, that this is the problem, which model you will apply, 90% class will fail. Because why? Because when I was going to take one project, Viva, I just asked them simple question, which model have you applied? And the students are not able to give the answer, which means that they just know what is a model, but how to apply that model, they don't know. And that's why unemployability, and that's how we don't push our limits. So discuss the problem, whether it is interesting enough or not. So research is a game, everybody. Most important, everybody, now understand, research is a game for which you have to set the rules. But the most important thing is it cannot be a trivial one. So make your own rules. What are your constraints? What is the maximization? What we have to do in order to find the solutions? And that's how the research starts. Okay, so that's how we have to make the final. So now let us talk of what is engineering research. Now let us come to the main topic today. Now you will all agree with me. I have already seen some of the comments that you all agree with me that today why India is crying, that why the Indian engineers are not employable, why we are producing so many engineers, but why the engineers are not employable. The only answer is we actually start with the wrong activity. So engineering is all about optimization. How you engineer a product, it is about optimization. Okay, we have the Nokia 5110, we have Nokia 3310. Now we have optimized from iPhone. We have taken the engineer from a landline phone to the smartphones. Now we want to go for foldable phones. We want to go for head-up displays. What we can do? Imagine the fighter plane in the World War I and imagine the fighter plane of today. A sky and earth difference. It's all about technology, hardships and challenges. So engineering research, which means that research is to find out the limits and the better way to optimization. How we can optimize. Now imagine, everybody, if I tell you, okay, let's go 10 years back. What you will do? You will say, answer one thing, that maybe you will not be able to say that, okay, Windows 98 will be enough for you today. Windows 98 was there, even the research was going there, but today you have Windows 10. How you can push your limits on that? So this is how we have to think creatively. So engineering is about invention, but engineering research is not. So research is what? Is to explain why an invention works. You have to explain in your thesis how you can make this thing work. This is called research. So what you're doing is to doing the engineering in order to invent something, but research is to explain that how it will work, how it will improve your results, how it will make your life better. Let's research on it. Now I give you a simple question. Now give me this answer. I give you a simple question. Now take your budget to 5,000 rupees. And I know many people will skip this exercise, but do this exercise. Okay. Go to Amazon.in and take a budget of 5,000. You don't have to buy anything. Just make a cart. Log into Amazon.in and consider that you have a target of 5,000 and you just have to make a smart home. Now you have to make lots of gadgets, but you have to make smart home. Now, don't think that you have to buy a Google Home or an Amazon Alexa or a smart lightning or a smart fan or a smart TV. You have a budget of 5,000. I want that you have to change the face of the room. Now you have 5,000 rupees as a constraint and you have to give me value. You have to maximize my room output and optimization. Now do your research that what activities you will do, what equipments you will buy. So that is actually how you are doing linear programming and you are optimizing your results in order to find what are the solutions for that. This is actually meant by real-time research. That's how we have to optimize. Okay, that is research. So engineering research is not science nor empirical science. It's basically the known as the foundations for science and research. That is what engineering research. It evolves from science and arts as well as a evolution from one thing to another thing. So it is close to applied mathematics as well as applied sciences. And the most important thing, everybody, very few people say about it. A good engineer needs not to be a good researcher. And even a good researcher need not to be a good engineer. Steve Jobs, he knows that how to sell the product. He has never written a particular code. He has never invented something. He was a man how to make a product, and he was a person who can make the things better. He was an innovator. He was just a mind thinker. He was just an entrepreneur. He was a businessman. But he was an excellent technologist because why? He has never written a code. He has never done any design or embedded system. He just know how to make the things work, and he does the work from the people. What he suits. And that's why we can say Apple. And that's why today, if you ask me, sir, which are the three top creative companies, I don't take even IBM. I take three companies as a number top. Number one is Apple. The number two, Nvidia. And number three, which I always take as one of the best companies for innovation, that is Google. So according to me, these three companies are actually producing not engineers or even the research. They're actually producing innovations that actually becomes a part of us. Now imagine, everybody, just ask yourself whether you want to start up company, whether you are designing that product, that whether you can change your life. How can you change your life with that product? Are you doing the research in right direction? That is how we have to say. So different levels, everybody. The level one is known as assistant. Level one is research assistant. Be assistant for everybody. I would like to tell you a short story about me, everybody. Very short story. I would not take much time. I started computer science when I was in the age of six. At the age of six. And when I was at age of 10, I was able to take a screwdriver and I was just able to open the fan. I was just able to open the mixie of my home, etc. And when the students come in the mere hot, they try to take a drink and they try to sleep. I used to take my cycle and I just go to an electrician store and I try to find more things about that. So the main thing is how to solve a problem. How was assistant? I was even learning. Today, even if any person knows something and I tell him, make me as your assistant. Because if you're assistant, which means you're learning. So level one, research assistant. Be a research assistant for everybody. Learn the drill. Learn the drill. Level two, homework like research. Research should be homework. Build up your confidence. Level three, formulate the problem and solve it. Your own problem, how you can optimize it. Can we improve like this? Can we do like this? Even I used to take the, you can say, a dead televisions at my home. I used to have a small room in my home, and I used to bring some dead gadgets like an electrician fan or a mixie oven, etc. And I tried to solve them. I tried to build something new. I tried to take some components and I tried to build some new component. And I was learning like anything. Even though I was not doing electronics and I don't know circuits, but at that time I was even teaching some of the students who were having some electronic and circuit design problems. At the age of 15, I was teaching. So exercise your creativity. Level four, formulate problems for others to solve. And that is what the Steve Jobs came. And that's what the guides came. If he's a real guide, he will give the problems that how we can solve it. Realize your vision. And last but not the least, knowing what to do is more important than knowing how. So ask yourself, what are you doing exactly? What exactly do you want to design rather than knowing how? If you are in a straight vision that, okay, I want to develop like this, then all your steps will be in the right direction. Otherwise, you are in the wrong direction. So what is good research? Novelty, simplicity, universality, which means the first research that is known from your side. And even let me tell you, everybody, if you just search internet of drones, internet of nano things, I have given seven terminologies of IoT to the whole world. You are talking to one of the person who is actually given the concept of internet of drone things. I even gave the concept of internet of underwater things. I am the first person on the planet who designed his own LoRaWAN. So these things keep me different, keep me new, keep me updated. That is what we have to see. You recognize the good research results if it is all keep up to the night, feeling like your first stage. I always say everybody, I don't feel shame in saying everybody. I'm not married in the age of 36. I dedicated my whole life to the research. Computer is like my wife and my lab is like my girlfriend. I love my wife, I love my girlfriend. And that is what you can say when I meet them, because when I start my journey every day, I meet them like I'm loving both of them, and I'm on the first date in order to keep myself updated. Because if I love them, they will love them me. And that is what we have to make the good production of the research. I dedicated my whole life to my research. So how to do research and what are the common misunderstandings? That is what we have to understand now. So think research is only for the genius. No, it is not for genius. Everybody can do the research. Even if you can you can give a small slate board to the girl child, even the children, when they solve a particular problem, like with the maze, when they decide a particular shape, that how they can make a building block, even they are doing their research that how to make a building block. Yes. Think yourself as a genius. No. Always learning. Never that, okay, I'm the number one. No. Think you need to know everything that is subject in advance. No. Subject is always improving. Keep on learning. Misconception. And think you should wait for the most important problem to work. No, it should not. And last but not the least, think a solution is correct, just you can't find anything. So very important, these five steps will be actually having the misunderstandings for all of you. So how to do research? Be confident and be humble. Very important. Be crucial and collaborative. All be critical to your thinking. Always, I'm saying always everybody, even I'm a scientist today, I always give my papers to some of the professors in Korea, China, Switzerland, Sweden, USA. I tell them, sir, fire this paper like anything. Give me the comments like anything. And ladies and gentlemen, today I'm sitting on 75 SCA papers. And believe me, in that 75 SCA papers, only 3 times I got some rejection, but otherwise I got minor revision. So be open to collaboration and critical thinking. Be open for criticism. Be ambitious and realistic. I want to improve. I want to do more publication. I want to solve this particular problem. I have to be motivated in myself. And be willing to take the chance. And the only way to improve yourself is to learn things that you are most afraid of. Always strike at your weak points, because your weak points will always become your highest, strongest points. Because at the strong point, you always think that you are strong and you become weak. But if you strike at your weak points, you will be a strong man. So have an endless cycle between excitement and depression. So don't take it as a depression, take it as a journey. And endless cycles between the success and failure. And even today, when I get a paper like, okay, it is out of scope, maybe it is rejected due to these reasons, I feel happy that at least I'm getting a chance to improve myself. I'm getting the chance to add more things in that. I'm getting the chance that, okay, maybe this journal is inferior for us. Thank God it is rejected. Now I can improve myself and I can get it to the best journal. An endless cycle between overconfidence and self-doubt, very important. And research needs faith and interesting work. And then we can say that we are making the world a better place, not with the publications, but with the solutions. So I hope everybody now feels some motivated, okay? Now we take a break for 2 minutes. After that, we start the next lecture. So if there's any question from your side till now, please ask it. After that, I will be telling you how to actually develop an effective research proposal, which is the first step for PhD and even for your postdocs. Very important. And even this is going to be an eye-opener session for all of you, that if you write an email to a professor that, okay, sir, we want to collaborate with you, we want to have some joint publication with you, so how you should give them some proposal and how you should write some big proposal to towards your PhD, this is going to discuss after this.
Okay, sir.
Any question? Any question, everybody? Age is not a matter for research. I started research at the age of 6, I told you. In the age of 17, I got my first publication. Even I was in my school. I did my systems engineering. I did my CCNA in the age of 15. I was a full systems engineer before the age of 18. Today, I'm having 75 certifications. And if you search Publons, you can search my name. I'm right now in the age of 36. I am the world's number 2 reviewer as per Web of Science and Computer Science. connected to almost 78% of the journals in the world. Almost. Madam, any question from the participant, please ask them. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay. Sir, how to search for collaborators beyond your university? So the main thing is that I will be giving you some tools tomorrow. There you can post your publication, you can make your profile. And the most important thing to start collaboration is to have your research interest joint. And secondly, you should have some good publications in your hand. Because the first thing that we see when I will be talking tomorrow is when we start for collaboration, I first of all see the ResearchGate score, and then I see the scholar, and then I see the Scopus. So if you have these three things good, then I'm interested for collaboration. Otherwise, I'm not interested. Okay. So how to work on statistics, which we would be better for our area of research, please throw some light on statistics. So I'm not a statistician. So as I'm working on data science, but I can give you some light of data science. So as we know that the statistics is laying the foundation for machine learning and deep learning. So you can go for some data science based analytics oriented research for healthcare. You can add some statistical modeling for, you can say for some game theory, you can add some statistical modeling to solve some information theory problems or the drone problems that you can do in order to find some good research over there. That is what you can do. But actually I'm a man of computer science. So if there is a computer science based question, so I'm mostly interested for that. Yeah, Mr. Muthu Viraj has told that I'm interested in research, but I'm not able to finalize the problem. I will be telling you how to finalize the problem after this lecture. Okay, so sit back, relax. I'm having lots of things to be covering up to you. Okay, for planning the course from AI from the scratch, I would like to request you that first of all, read some good book of AI. And after that, you can enroll to some course from Coursera or Class Central. And after that, you can have some more things in terms of AI. But for the AI, I would like to request you that your mathematics as well as your statistics should be very, very strong. And secondly, your algorithm section, because AI requires a strong foundation, theoretical computer science, and then you can go for geotagging or other basic applications. Sir, what about new PhD scholars, how they can get collaborators? Actually, that is challenging, but I will be telling you how to actually find the particular guide and how to actually start your PhD and write the thesis tomorrow. Can you say any challenges related to data science with education? Yes, it is challenging. And for data science, I would like to request you that you can have some student behavior and you can find some deep learning oriented, you can say strategy in the class, that what is the mood of the students and how they feel motivated. And for the data science, we can solve lots of problems in order to understand that how we can improve the research and how we can make a model for teaching in order to improve our e-teaching, as well as to improve the pedagogy for teaching with latest subjects. Like we can do that. Sorry, I am not into this area, astrophysics, so I'm sorry for that. Madam, we will start in 1 minute, okay?
Okay, sir.
After this, madam, we will be covering today how to read a research paper and then we go for grants. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So there are lots of things to be discussed today. Yeah, that is what I'm working actually these days on insight of machine learning on agriculture domain and crop production. So you have machine learning models. So the most important thing is to find a data sets. The main thing is to find the images. And after that, you can learn the machine learning model. Like we can have the MNIT data set. And we can use the TensorFlow, we can use Keras or even scikit-learn, these type of tools with Python in order to make some prediction for the crop diseases. We can make this type of area, but the main thing is that you must have the data. And after that, you can use SVM, random forest, or even linear regression in order to classify the disease. You can make clustering also, and you can find the prediction and the validity using supervised learning, and then you can go for unsupervised learning. Yes, there are lots of applications with regard to data science, with regard to drones especially. So we are expecting, like, because my specialization is to visualize the mathematical modeling of a machine, like a law of nature, and after that I use information information theory and control theory in order to make some mathematical models and to construct them into an algorithm, and that algorithm is being implemented using some high-end computer programs in order to be fed into the embedded systems. So my specialization in drone is to have the object detection, object correlation, object modeling, as well as computer vision. So this is various areas I'm doing my research in drone, because even I'm a drone pilot also. Yes, it is very good. No, it is not stagnant now. Image processing as a research domain, you can go for medical image processing, which is very, very important. And if you ask me, you can see my latest paper on pneumonia detection and even on cancer detection. Even I'm coming up with my own new chapter, which is going to be the biggest chapter ever written in the world. That will be breast cancer, in which we have added some data science as well as machine learning models and deep learning model, how to detect the breast cancer at even pre-stage. Okay, so that is what we have done, discuss our research on that. Okay, madam, can we start now?
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be another eye-opener session for you, because after that, we will be completing all the foundation steps, and now you will be ready to understand how to improve your research as well as to go for research tools and how to write the effective research paper. Okay, so before I will wind up the lecture, I will be showing you one diagram, which is actually constructed by me, and it is actually tweaked by me. And after that, I will be sharing that diagram with all of you day after tomorrow. So please see that diagram. Rest we will be discussing tomorrow. Okay, because today's lecture is to make a foundation as well as to discuss what mistakes we make in the research and to keep yourself motivated. Now the question stands, everybody, the first step. Now, I've already told you that most of the people now ask me the question that, sir, how we start our research, what we should write in our research paper, how we should write a draft to the proposal. So the first important thing that the people make the mistake, that the people come blank to the guide. This is wrong. So if you are really interested for the research proposal or everything, you have to start with developing an effective research proposal. Because even if today, like, suppose I've already told you that even if you want to do postdoc with me or you want to do PhD with me, it doesn't mean that, okay, you have the paper, you have a resume. It is not okay. It is just a 50% component. So the rest of the component, 50%, is your proposal. That I want to know that what is your proposal, what is the problem that you want to solve, what is the outcome that you can expect, and why do you think that this is going to be a novel solution? Because in international universities, the most important stress is towards the research, what outcome and what problem-oriented solution that we are going to derive with it. So that is what we have to see, and we have to design an effective research proposal. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this lecture. This is going to change another vision for all of you. So what you will learn in this lecture right now, how to write a proposal in a university to start your PhD, postdoc, and collaboration. Now, this is important, everybody. Now, I've already told you that I get lots of emails every day that, sir, we want to write a paper with you. Sir, we want to have collaboration with you. Sir, we want to do some research with you. And the people don't give me a particular idea that, okay, sir, this is the problem that we are working and this is what we want to solve with you. Okay, so I want to have some particular area. I want to have a particular reason in order to do that. And similarly, how to write the proposal. This is very important for you to understand that how to write a proposal for the research grant, because after this, I will be telling you how to actually file the research grant. Now, the components, very important. This is what you have to see when you're going for a PhD or even for your postdoc or even for collaboration, very important. So the preliminary pages, introduction, statement of the problem, research objectives, questions, thesis, like a hypothesis that we are going to discuss, literature view, limitations, design, resources, work schedule, content, and references. So ladies and gentlemen, please take a picture of this photo of this screen, because I'm not going to share this presentation with all of you. So please take a picture of the screen. And these are the important components that you should be ready in your presentation when you're applying for postdoc or even your PhD in a foreign university, or even you're looking for a collaborator that, okay, sir, you have a lab and I'm the particular person, how you will start your collaboration. So these important components are actually required. Okay. Please take the photo. I will be telling you, and please note it down. Very, very important. Now, let us talk about some of the important preliminary pages. So the first important thing is title page. Now the people make mistake, just write the name, nothing else. No, this is wrong. So write your title, write the name of the researcher, what is the degree type, what is your department and date of the submission. Please write a particular page that what is going to be done from your side. Second is a table of contents, headings and subheadings, and then abstract. I will be telling you what is the tip. And let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, right now, the most difficult component in the research paper today, I'm telling you on this platform, and I'm telling again to every platform, is the abstract part. Because if your abstract is not good, let me tell you, editor-in-chief will actually reject your paper. It's a mentality. So please make it sure that your abstract should be perfect. And I will be telling you tomorrow how to actually write an abstract. Whether you are an astrophysicist, whether you are a geologist, whether you are a statistician, you can have the complete knowledge tomorrow that how to actually write the research paper components and how to actually write the abstract. Very important, one and two paragraphs. So the second part is the introduction. So even I'm telling you how to actually write a conference paper or a Scopus paper, you have to write these components. Introduction. So introduction should always contain your area that, okay, sir, I want to work in the cloud computing. This is the area. And after that, you should list that which topic do you want to work. That, okay, in cloud computing, we have virtualization, we have load balancing. Okay, sir, I want to work in cloud computing, but I want to work in the area for security. So what is your area? What is your topic? What is the background? Okay, and brief literature view that what is the current research being conducted, that, okay, sir, this is the good area. Security is a problem. Attacks are happening. And till date, this is the problem that is being struggled. And now we have to work on this type of area. So please make a broader coverage. So introduction should only contain the area, the scope, and the main methodology, the base ground that is being taken to provide your research that, okay, what you want to do. So that is what we want to understand in the first point, that, okay, sir, if you are taking a PhD, what is your broad area? That, okay, sir, I'm working in cloud computing, but what you're working in cloud in security. And after that, now you will talk that, okay, sir, now we will list the papers, that these are the papers for a security in cloud computing. Let me study, let me find out what is being done and what is the problems in current study. And that is my research, that, okay, sir, let us take these papers and let us improve something. Then only you can collaborate that, okay, sir, I have studied this much of literature and now I would like to give you my objectives. So the objective will be that what is not being done and what you want to propose by taking the existing works. Now, let me give you the brief explanation. Now, statement, very important, everybody. See this. Now, listen carefully, thoroughly. This is important for your paper also. What to do and why. Now, many people don't understand that in the introduction section, but maybe I will repeat it tomorrow also. In the introduction section, there is some objectives also. But 90% of the papers which I see that, okay, sir, we will perform literature. No, that is a part. That is not your objective. So the first objective will be to analyze the various weaknesses of the existing works. That, okay, sir, these works are being analyzed and we will add these components to make this work. Okay, sir, in security, now the security was only cryptographically, but now we will improve the security via blockchain technology. How you will improve the security? And after that, what you will do? Okay, sir, we will propose a novel framework. We will propose an architecture. We will make a model. And why we will make the model? Because these attacks are happening with this blockchain technology. Now I'm able to defend these attacks. So the structure should be your principle, your interaction, and even your speculation that what is going to be and what experimentation I will conduct. So the first important objective, so this is your PhD thesis, everybody. There should be 4 to 5 objectives. So the first thing should be what you will analyze and what you are going to do. Second thing, what you are going to propose, how you will going to propose and how the thing will be able to work. What experimentation will be done in order to validate your approach? And fifth, how you will test the novelty that, okay, sir, this is my approach and I will compare with this approach and this approach. So these 4 or 5 objectives are actually being there in order to draft the proposal or even if you want to write your thesis. So objectives, very important, everybody. So see this, indicate precisely what you intend to achieve. Okay, sir, I will improve the security by adding blockchain technology, by adding cryptography, by adding novel security methodology. I will propose my own algorithm that is based on MD5. I will propose my own routing protocol. I will propose my own theoretical science. how you will propose in that. So consider it as a proof of project, how you will measure. Okay, so which means that how you will design the model and how you will measure the model in terms of its success. What are the resources available? Very important. Okay, sir, I will do experimentation on live sensors. I will do experimentation on cloud center. I will use this simulator. Very important. Then you should find out what is the overall goal of the project. Okay, sir, I will improve throughput. I will improve security. I will improve delivery ratio. I will improve modeling. I will find the solution to this formula. This is my overall goal and how it can be achieved. So this is how the objectives will come when you draft the proposal. And that's how the university will be able to understand that this is your objective. This is how you are able to proving that, okay, this is your novelty and this is the novel work. So the most important thing towards importance is focus on the study, give the direction towards the design, prevent irrelevant material. So only study. I will be telling you tomorrow what are the tools are there. And tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen, don't miss the lecture, because I will be telling you some of the tools through which I'm granting you today. Your searching of the papers will become a child play for you. There are some websites that will do work for you. Yes, they will do work for you. You don't have to work with them. They will do the work for you by just searching the keywords. I will be telling you tomorrow the tools, most important, practically. Organize your study and criteria how you will outcome the study, which means how you will improve your parameters, how the parameters will be improvised. Now see this, everybody. Now this is important. Now these are the verbs that you should use. Identify. Okay, sir, I will identify what problems, opportunities, etc. I will define, I will describe, I will explore, generate, evaluate, select, test. Whether you are into physics, mathematics, chemistry, biomedical engineering, computer science, you should use only these terminologies into your objectives. Other than, there is no other terminology that should be used. Otherwise, it is false. So select, test, measure, prioritize, monitor, and track. So these methodologies, take a photo of this slide also, and take a photo of this first left-hand side, important, because these are the sample words that you should use in your PhD thesis. That, okay, sir, this is my novelty, and this is how I will define, I will explore, I will test, I will evaluate, and I will track the performance. So you can use either of the four methodologies depending on your subject. Okay, because I can only give you the computer science, because I'm into computer science. I cannot give you a physics or astrophysics or any other allied subjects. I'm not specialized in that. So you should use only these methodology verbs in order to design your research objectives. Now, what are the examples? See this, everybody. Now, I have given you some examples to find out the methods used for water treatment, to determine the feeding habits of under fives, to assess the perception of community regarding care and support for people with HIV/AIDS, which means today, if you're working on COVID-19, you can assess the performance of the people that are having COVID and those who are not having COVID. And after that, you can use AI in order to detect the symptoms. You can do the pre-staging. You can design a model. And after that, you will evaluate the model. So that is how you can use these type of objectives, these type of verbs, find out, determine, assess. So these verbs are very important for all of you. Don't use any other verbs in your objectives. Very important. So the most important thing is your research question. What is your research question? What is the objective of study? Answer your questions and sub-questions. So this you can find the correlation. Okay, sir, I am having a question that, okay, are we able to study the routing algorithm? Are we able to study the optimality? Can we design a mathematical model in order to optimize this routing frequency? Can we design a signal? Can we design an optimized signal in order to reduce the Doppler effect? So these type of things will be actually giving you the examples that what are the main studies that we will be conducting. So under the thesis, you can do, this is only for the management, but I just give you a brief explanation. So under this, you can use your statistics in order to define whether the research hypothesis will be accepted or whether it will be a null hypothesis if you are doing some primary study or secondary study based on questionnaire. So I just come to this one now, literature review. Now, everybody, please listen to me. Very important. Now, let me give you some example like this. Now, please listen to me. Now, the first important thing for literature review, what is to be done? Now, the first people, they make the mistakes. Now, suppose the paper is written by Anand Nair. Now, understand carefully. And it is written by Rameshwar Singh. Suppose there are the two authors. And 90% people, they make the mistake. They write the full name of the authors. Now, this is wrong. You should write Nair and Singh. And after that, you should write the number that, okay, this paper is at number two. And one important thing, please note it down. Literature review should always be written in the past tense, because these papers and the works are already done. This is the past research. Okay. So like you can say proposed, derived, measured. Okay. What is to be done? What is done? First of all, you should write what is done. They conceptualized a routing protocol. They proposed a theory. After that, write one line. What is done? What is being done? Write in one line. Now I'm giving you one paper. I can say, write in that paper what is going to be. And after that, write what conclusions or experimentations that they have done. So this is how in four lines you should write your literature review. Okay. Now suppose, now I come over here and this is where the people make mistakes. Now suppose if the paper has one author or two author, only use the second name. This is Nair, this is Singh, Nair and Singh. Okay. But if the paper has three authors like Anand Nair, Shruti Sinha, and I can take another one, Ramesh Kumar. Now over here, people again make the mistakes. Now I would like to share one important thing. If the paper has more than two authors, more than two, even if it is three or four, whatever it is, just take the first last name of the first author. Just take Nair and just write. Now, even their people make mistakes. They write like at full stop L. This is wrong. This is totally wrong. The at L should be like this one, at L dot. And after that, number three. After that, you can write what is being proposed, what is being done, what is experimented, and this is how. And after that, most of the people, they don't do this problem, and this is going to be the major problem. Now, after you have written the literature of 20 papers or 15 papers, write in 9 to 10 and 13 lines, I can say, what overall gaps you have studied. What overall gaps? That, okay, after studying this, we found that some of the protocols that are being produced, they are having less into throughput, they are having problems with efficiency, they are not secure. Okay, sir, by reviewing the literature, I can able to understand that the security of cloud computing is not being highlighted properly. It is not demonstrated practically. They have the encryption of up to 128 bit, which means what is the problem by this existing literature? And this will be your problem that you will study in your PhD. So these gaps will be the problem statement, the motivation to formulate your research in order to propose your novel work. So this is the problems that you have to understand. So that's all. That is why the literature review is the foundation stone. This is going to be the number one aspect in your paper. So if you're writing a research paper, don't start with introduction, start with literature review. That is the answer, everybody. Note it down. So I hope everybody is understanding. Okay. So the most important thing is to have the justification, and please add the existing knowledge. What are the implications and what will be the benefits? I've already told you this one. So I just come to this one now. They're very important because I just want to wind up this lecture now. So research design and methods, we should be designing. What is the design? How you will design a protocol. Okay, I will design a protocol. I will design a methodology. I will design an architecture. I will make a framework. I will make a, you can say, a software. I can make an app. Whatever it is, what is the design of your problem? So specific methods, what will be the sample, data collection, validity, collection procedure, dealing with ethical plans, analysis, plans for findings, everything should be clear in research design. So the availability of resources is very important. You can say that you should design what are the equipments that, okay, sir, I will do my research on this embedded system. I will do this research on drone. I will do this simulator, MATLAB or other things, materials, literature, human resources, data, budget, everything. So that's what we don't write in the proposal. And that is what we have to write before you start with the collaboration and postdocs. So this is your work schedule, everybody. This you should write that, okay, sir. Now this is the main thing that I have made it for you. Now, the first important thing is to identify your research area. Very, very important, everybody. First of all, study. Okay, many people give me the email, sir, I want to do research in computer science, what I should do? There are tons of subjects here. I should know that, okay, you are interested in cloud computing. Okay, please study on these areas. So identify the research area. Formulate your questions. What is the problem connected to that area? What is the main situations in this area? Formulate the strategy. Formulate the design. Write the proposal. Negotiate the access. Then do the literature review. Then start with the research problems that, okay, I'm reading the papers. Do the collection of the papers. Analysis. Write the first and second draft. And then you can go with the thesis. So this is actually how, everybody, you should do your PhD. This is how we actually formulate the particular research in a particular order. So the proposed content can be outline of chapters like introduction. You can say this could be your PhD thesis chapter also. Introduction, literature review, research design, analysis or experimentation, summary, conclusions, and recommendations. So this could be your synopsis. This could be your PhD thesis. This could be your project report. Whatever you want to have, you can do like this. And after that, we can have references. I will be telling you how to do references, and people do this problem like this. Now, suppose if you want to go for references, just go for this one like scholar.google.com. Now, I don't know how many people know about this or not. So suppose if you want to search for a reference, like suppose if I take any paper like cloud computing load balancing issues. So if suppose I'm searching like this and I want to cite this paper. Now, rather than you go to Mendeley, you just click on this one, double quotes, click on over here and you can find this API. Just copy paste that. This is how the references we will be using in order to do the research paper. So don't write references on your own. We can have this type of references like this. So the most important question should be that in order to have an effective proposal, it should be straightforward, simple language, precise, clearly organized, and it should contain all the necessary information. So I wish you all the best. Now you should understand that how to write the research proposal, what you should do in order to make your guide presentable, when you should read the paper, literature review, and what mistakes we can find. Okay. So this is how we can find the best of luck for that.
Vijendra sir, please summarize the sir what he what they explained today, sir.
Hello.
Take a break for 5 minutes. After that, we will start the next lecture. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Madam, after 5 minutes, we will start the final lecture, Fundamentals of Grant Writing.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
That will be the final lecture for today.
Okay, sir.
Meanwhile, if you have any question, please.
स्वरूप मैडम फोन
हाँ Yeah, the question has come. So, sir, while performing literature review, is it necessary to write the research gap for each paper? No, it is not necessary to write the research gap for every paper. Even I've got one thesis in which every gap was written, so gap should be overall. Cloud Sim simulator, yes, it can be there, but it is a very limited simulator, so you cannot validate your research in terms of your data, except from data center virtualization. So that's a very limited simulator. Okay, ma'am, we can wind up the lecture today. We can continue with this lecture tomorrow. Okay?
Oh, it's okay, sir. You talk, 1 minute, sir. 1 minute. Yeah. Vijayendra, sir, is going to...
If you want to wind up today, we can wind up tomorrow. We can start with the grant writing research tools, and then we can start with the, that is how to write the effective research paper. We can have time tomorrow. No problems.
Okay, sir. Well, yeah. Just a minute, sir. Vijayendra, yes. Sir.
Okay. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. It was a wonderful session. Our FDP on high quality research approach design wonderfully covered the approach. You answered basic question, who can be a researcher? And the basic statement which I liked and also quote now is, research is not a job, it is a hobby. So anybody who takes that in a right stride can be a researcher. So next, you also covered whoever has apprehension that, can I be a researcher? Am I going to be a successful researcher? Yes, everybody can be a successful researcher if he has got that dedication and commitment that you have brought out wonderfully. And I can see through this chat box, everyone has appreciated your lecture. They have thoroughly enjoyed it, and you have stick to the basic objectives of this overall FDP. Particularly today, you have covered the approach and part of the design of research. Tomorrow, I'm damn sure that you are going to be very elaborative in the design and also publishing the research outcomes. And today, the main design part you have covered is identifying the problem, and you have stressed wonderfully that how to be prepare a problem statement, then go on to literature review, and again come back to problem statement, restate based on the research. So it is an iterative procedure, a design method. Finally, you are going to finalize that. Indeed, it was well taken. And also, it was very much interactive, and I personally liked your way of presenting the things, giving the breaks, intermittently asking for the interactions. So that has made our job also very simple, because we had an interactive session we had kept at the end. Professor Vidya wanted to interact, conduct that session. I hand over this, and today I hope most of the participants today will join us tomorrow to know the publishing and the remaining part of the design and methods of the research.
Tomorrow it will be more on practical sessions, sir, and I will be putting up more on live sessions, like how to write a research paper, what are the components, how to write the particular components.
Okay, that will be wonderful. That would be wonderful. Now I hand over the session to Vidya Madam to give a vote of thanks and conclude today's program. Over to Vidya.
Thank you, sir. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Before I conclude, I would like to say a quoting from Michael Gell. Research shows that you begin learning in the womb and go right on learning until the moment you pass on. Your brain has a capacity for learning that is virtually limitless, which makes every human a potential genius. Sir, it's indeed a great honor that we have you with us this evening for an inspirational talk on high quality research. Thank you so much, sir, for the wonderful session. We'll be waiting for tomorrow's session.
Sure.
Thank our principal for giving us support in conducting such seminar and webinars. And also thank conveners, Dr. Rupa Madam and Vijayendra, sir. Thank all the participants for their active interaction. Thank you, one and all. Have a great evening.